About a century ago, German art historian Waringer distinguished two aesthetic regimes, the organic and the crystalline.
The crystalline represents a will to abstraction. When a culture feels that it is in conflict with the world, that events are chaotic and hostile, it tends to produce pure geometric forms as an attempt to pattern and transcend this chaos.
Gilles Deleuze adapts this notion in his second book on cinema, The Time Image, to theorize on the notion of the time crystal. Whereas an organic image shows the object directly, a crystalline description is more provisional and contingent. It replaces the object, continually erasing it and creating it anew, giving way to other equally adequate descriptions, which may also modify or contradict the ones preceding it. In the crystalline, it is now the description itself which constitutes the decomposed and multiplied object. Crystalline images presuppose a special relationship between perception and memory. For each actual description of a physical object, there corresponds a virtual memory image of the mind and memory. The virtual image is recollected from chains of associations and memories of past experiences. Each time a virtual image is called up in relation to an actual description, the object depicted is deformed and created anew, widening and deepening the mental picture it inspires.
To put it very simple, one can paraphrase this with a line from the song Life is Life from the Slovenian band Laibach. Jeder Augenblick der Zukunft ist ein Gedanke an vorher. Every minute of the future is a memory of the past. One of the key features of the mix of actual and virtual, real and memory, is indiscernibility. This term, indiscernibility, refers to the state of being indistinguishable. The real and imaginary become indistinguishable in a crystalline description. The crystal rewrites the relations between the forms of the true and the powers of the false. It fractures them into many facets and interweaves their emissions. This indistinguishable remix of the real and the virtual is the key to understand what Deleuze means by a crystalline image. Like an image produced in a mirror, it always has two poles, actual and virtual. However, it is often difficult to decide what is an actual image and what is a reflection. What this indiscernibility makes visible is the ceaseless fracturing or splitting of non-chronological time.